Hello gorgeous people, this is Chris from Macombo and I'm here with the Black Shark gaming phone. Now gaming phones suddenly seem to be very en vogue indeed. We've obviously just had the Razer Phone 2, sequel to last year's original Razer Phone. We've also got the ROG Phone, the Republic of Gamer Phone from Asus, and now the Black Shark phone as well. Not really a massive surprise considering how popular mobile gaming is with the likes of PubG, Fortnite, stuff like that, hitting our mobile devices. Now, unlike the likes of the Razer Phone 2 and the ROG Phone, the Black Shark phone is actually surprisingly affordable. It's also just £439 here in the UK, yet despite that, rocks some really premium specs and also boasts, as far as we can tell, much better gaming features than the likes of the Razer Phone 2. So let's get it fully unboxed, get it set up, and have a bit of a tour of the hardware and the software so you know exactly what to expect from the Black Shark phone. And don't forget, of course, for more unboxings and full-on reviews of latest and greatest mobile tech, to hit subscribe and ding that notifications bell. So, your gamer. Yeah, cool. Never yielding, let's shark. These kind of sound like parody slogans that you'd get thrown at you by something like Black Mirror, but okay. So there is the actual Shark phone itself. Oh, very nice and snazzy, very weighty as well. Just put that aside for a second. We'll just see what else you get in the box, because it sounds like a good one, certainly from the description. So you can see a very black box. Everything inside of it is black, including the phone itself. All right, so you get a protective cover type thing. I believe that's probably also used in attaching the gamepad part of it. Here you also get a quick start guide, and I believe this is a screen protector as well, which is quite snazzy. You don't tend to get screen protectors is actually bundled in the box, occasionally pre-installed, but that's about it. And of course, a pokey pin device in order to actually get your SIM into the Wii Bugger. In here we also have a 3-pin plug in order to actually charge the thing up again. Always handy. You get, oh, I'm guessing this is a USB cable. Ah, Kel surprise. And also in there is a Type-C to 3.5mm headphone adapter as well, because there is no 3.5mm headphone jack actually on the phone itself. But at least you get that bundled in the box. And then finally, this should hopefully be the actual controller. There we go. So unlike the likes of the Razer Phone 2, as you can see, you do actually get a physical controller which you can attach to the Black Shark in order just to help with your everyday gaming. So we'll be testing that out in full, of course. Right, so with all that gubbins out of the way, let's actually check out the phone itself. Peel off this protective cover. And as you can see there, it's you're not gonna mistake that for anything other than a gaming phone, frankly. It's definitely got that sort of gamer vibe to it. Lots of weird angles, very funky design, for sure. If we take a tour of the rest of the handset as well, you've got your power button and your volume buttons over here on this side. Down beneath, just your Type-C USB, of course. Over on this side, you've got a little slider, which I believe is the Black Shark slider button, which brings up the funky gaming UI. We'll explore that certainly in detail in a second. Let's just try and get it powered up. Yeah, looks like we've got some juice in the tank. There we go. And you'll notice down here beneath the display as well, you actually have a built-in fingerprint sensor as well. I haven't seen one of those in a little while. Usually they're rear-mounted, or recently they've been built into the actual display itself. And of course, it's also quite strange to see a smartphone with a completely flat bezel up above as well. No little notches intruding on the display or anything like that, which is definitely good if you're going to be getting some gaming on the go, because it's nice to have something to clutch at the sides without your thumbs immediately straying onto the screen. So I'm just going to quickly get this phone set up now, and then we'll have a full-on tour of everything else. Okay, so we've finished the setup process and run a quick update, and now the Black Shark is ready for action. So let's start off by running through some of those specs. So it's a 6-inch IPS screen, 5.99-inch if you want to be all pedantic about it, and it's a full HD Plus panel as well. So not quite as crisp as the likes of the Razer Phone 2, which had a Quad HD Plus, but as you can see there, absolutely no problems with the tiny little text. Everything looks nice and sharp. Very crisp indeed, and sort of reasonably punchy colours as well from an IPS panel. So definitely no complaints there. Diving into the display settings, you see you do have sort of limited customization over it. So you've got a super cinema mode, which as you can see there, lifts the video frame rate, just optimizes video playback apparently. And you can have a bit of a play around with the color as well. So you've got it in cinema mode at the moment. You can have it in natural mode if you want more realistic colors. It does apparently cover 97% of the DCI-P3 color gamut. And you can chuck it on eye care mode as well, which of course just filters that blue light just for a more easy on the eye experience. And of course you've got the usual night light and everything as well. You can also play around with the navigation keys. As you can see, it's a virtual bar down beneath, but you can flip that about, hide it, and just use the gesture controls instead. I'm going to hide that because there's no point in actually having the touch back and recent apps buttons there, and then also virtual ones on screen. That seems a bit pointless. Apparently it's got dual stereo speakers as well. So yeah, so you've got blasters down beneath, and then I guess it uses the earpiece as well as a media speaker. Let's just give that a quick testing out with our favorite music video. Okay, let's just boost up that sound. Yeah, definitely coming through the top and the bottom speaker. Turn down for what? Actually, not a bad amount of bass out of it for a mobile phone, certainly. I'd say that's certainly up there with the likes of the Pixel 3, things like that. Actually, powering the show is the Snapdragon 845 chipset as well. Would you expect anything less from a gaming device? And it's backed by the 6 or 8 gigs of RAM, depending on which model you actually have. The 6 gigabyte model starts at $439, and I believe the premium 8 gig model costs $479. So even the most premium version of Black Shark costs a lot less than the likes of the Razer Phone 2. Pretty stunning specs all around considering that asking price. And you also get either 64 or 128 gigs of storage depending on which model you plumb for. As you can see, this is the 128 gigabyte model. There's no micro SD support though, so you are stuck with what you've got. So essentially, I'd say go for the 8 gig model with 128 gigs of storage. It makes sense just for the extra £40. As for the battery tech, it's a 4000 milliamp cell in there as well, so it matches the Razer Phone 2, slightly beats the likes of the OnePlus 6T, so definitely, hopefully, should give you all day battery life, even if you're doing a fair bit of gaming on the go. The Razer Phone 2 gave us about 5 hours of non-stop PubG action, so we're hoping to get at least that from this bad boy as well. And you've got Quick Charge 3, a bit of an older version of Quick Charge on board, to power you up again when needed. No support for wireless charging though, unlike the Razer Phone. As for the actual software, it's running a bit of stock Android. So as you can see here, Black Shark currently running 8.1.0, so Android Oreo. No sign of Android Pie just yet. Hopefully won't take too long to get that updated. And you do also have the Black Shark UI as well, which I was hoping you would get to. Oh yeah, here we go. So as you see, you just flick that side button and you enter Shark Space with a lovely little jingle. Lovely. And as you see, this basically turns the smartphone into console mode, giving you allegedly improved gaming experience. So as you can see there, you get a nice bit of uninterrupted gaming as well, basically block all notifications so people can go screw themselves when you're doing your PUBGs, your Fortnites. And you've got the usual game acceleration and everything as you would expect from a gaming mode as well. So let's enter Shark Space. This is exciting times. Oh, except of course I haven't actually downloaded any games, so kind of limited what we can do here. Give me one sec, guys. Right, oh look, we've got a game downloaded now. Excellent. So let's give this a go. First of all, of course, the interface is very, very simple in Shark Space. As you can see there, you've got a list of your games. If you click that on there, this gives you access to your data statistics, okay? So I'm guessing that'll tell you how much time you're actually wasting playing these mobile games. And then of course you've got the game controller as well. So let's get this connected now. So as you can see, all you need to do is just slip this extra little bit of plastic chassis action on there. And then with that done, you can then attach the gamepad. All you need to do is just slip the phone in like so, and they just click into place, and then they're held nice and solid once they're in place, as you can see there. To actually take it off again, what you need to do is push this little button here and then just slide it on out. But otherwise, yeah, they are housed firmly in there. Nice stuff. As you can see, this adds, of course, a little joystick. This adds a little button there, and you've got two shoulder buttons that you can play around with as well. So lots of stuff to help out with your fast-paced action games. All right, so let's start the game. And when you're actually in a game as well, you can pull down the gaming settings at any point just with a quick swipe down at the fingerprint sensor. As you can see there, now opened up the gaming menu. So this allows you to, for instance, actually set up the gamepad for whichever specific game that you are playing. As you can see there, you've got quick access to your Wi-Fi settings. You can say no calls while I'm playing, turn on the night mode, prevent the keypad from popping up, and lots more besides. So certainly seems to be pretty solid, and it even tells you how much the CPU and the GPU is being used up, and these handy little indicators as well. So you know if you're absolutely throttling the system. Of course, what I've gone and done is completely forgot to actually pair the gamepad with the smartphone. You do need to do that before you can actually use it. So there you go, as you can see there, we are now paired. And you do actually have to charge the gamepad as well, of course, because it has that Bluetooth support. You can do that using a bit of Type-C USB as well, so it charges the same way as the phone, so at least that's nice and easy. So I just loaded up a bit of cover fire, so this is just a basic, bog standard, simple arcade game. As you can see, it works absolutely fine with the gamepad straight out of the box, no need to set it up or anything first. But I'm guessing if you play the likes of PubGs, you will actually have to do the full controller customization, because obviously it's a bit more complex. But so far, certainly the joypad, everything seems nice and sensitive, just that right level of sensitivity. And it's nice that you've got one hand free for your touch controls and the other one on the joypad to get those sort of precision controls when needed. Oh dear, I'm getting shot to bits here. Yeah! So then once you're done, all you need to do is, as I say, just push in that top button, disconnect the phone from the joypad, and you can actually switch this off, I'm guessing, by long pressing this button here. By long pressing that button there. Get there in the end, and then flick this little slider switch down, and you're back into stock Android. And just take this little shell bit off. There we go. And then it's back to being just a standard Android phone. Or actually a really rather nice Android phone. As we've gone through most of the Black Shark specs and everything now, it's also just worth touching on the camera tech, of course, because always important. Even if you're going to be doing a lot of gaming on your smartphone, you'll also want to be taking some nice photos and videos as well. Now, it appears to have Xiaomi's sort of standard camera app on there. So as you can see, it's got a bit of the AI scene recognition built in. The actual hardware tech, as you can see there, it's a dual lens rear camera. And what you get is a 12 megapixel f1.75 primary lens, backed by a 20 megapixel, again f1.75 secondary lens. And I believe that secondary lens has a 2x optical zoom built in as well. So of course, because it's a dual lens setup, you get your nifty bit of portrait mode action. You can also shoot video at up to 4K resolution, I believe it is. Pretty much standard these days. Yep, there you go, full HD by default, but you can bump it up to 4K on demand. And basically looks like your typical Xiaomi setup, nice and simple. And if you dive into photos as well, see you've got a couple of bonus bits in there. Straight and tilt shift. You can of course beautify if you absolutely must. And if we swap it around to the front facing camera, it's a 20 megapixel effort. I believe it's an f2.2. And once again, you've got your portrait modes, except this time just using software smarts instead of an actual dual lens setup, because just the one lens. Take some sexy selfies. Oh, blurry selfie more like. Let's delete that one. Don't think that's a keeper. And you can also shoot it up to full HD resolution video as well. So what will be interesting to see is how good this camera tech is compared with the likes of the Razer Phone 2. Razer Phone 2, quite disappointing when it comes to the camera. So if the Black Shark can sport a really sexy bit of camera tech that shoots some nice, reliable, good-looking photos as well, then frankly, it will absolutely slay that Razer Phone. And that right there is the Black Shark smartphone. And that right there is the Black Shark gaming smartphone. As I say, available in the UK for around £439 to begin with, £479 if you want those slightly paired up specs. Definitely seems like a winner, so let us know what you think in the comments down below, and stay tuned for an in-depth review of this bad boy. I'll be using it as my full personal handset, so I'll be testing it for everyday phone functionality as well as the actual gaming stuff as well. Lots of PubG for me, yay! And don't forget to poke subscribe and ding that notifications bell for more on the latest and greatest mobile tech. Cheers everyone, love you!